I am one of the volunteers of the English ministry, and we are so glad you are here for participate from this special moment for all of us. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we are going to worship God with our singing, with praying, and with the scripture that we'll be preaching this afternoon. Amen. So prepare your heart to receive and prepare your heart to worship God with your heart. Let's pray. Lord, thank you for this opportunity to participate of this moment, Lord. Thank you that you have chosen us to be part of this purpose on the earth. And we are here, Lord, to worship you. Receive our worship, Lord. May the Holy Spirit come. Holy Spirit, come and fill this place with your presence. Fill our hearts, fill everyone here, Lord. Fill this place. And may your love run over this place. And be glorified. You are worthy to receive the glory, honor, and the power. Let's worship God together. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Jesus. Aleluia. He's worthy. honor of all. And now we give you honor, we give you glory, Lord. Your presence is real here. Your presence is here. And Father, I pray that you come and touch every heart tonight. In the name of Jesus, touch our hearts. And that we want to say, Lord, have your way in our lives, in our minds, in our thoughts, in our families, in our finances. Have your way, Lord, in our businesses, in our professions, in everything. Because you are the Lord of our lives. You are the Lord of our lives. And have it all in our lives, Lord. Oh, I surrender to you. Just close your eyes. Feeling here. Spiritual refreshment again. Hallelujah. Oh, just open your heart. Open your heart to feel that. To feel. Oh, the touch of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
are struggling in your finances, and God is calling your attention to Him, to say to you, my son, my daughter, come, because before I bless you, I want to teach you how to manage the money that I will trust you. Believe that God wants to prosper some of your financial. So stretch your hands, let's pray for this man that you brought here. Father, thank you very much for your faithfulness. Thank you for your goodness, Lord. Your word says that your mercy and your goodness are following us all the days of our lives. And we give you honor and glory, God, because we don't belong to this system, to this world system. We belong to heavens. We belong to the culture of heavens. We belong to the kingdom of God and in our finances. Our finances will not flow according to this worldly system. Our finances will flow according to the kingdom of God. And we praise you, God, because you have been teaching us how to manage everything that you trusted us. And we give to you our tithes and our offerings in recognition that you are the owner of our lives, God. And I receive it, and I pray for those who have managed this money here in the church. I pray, Lord, that you give them wisdom, that you give them the fear of the Lord to manage this money, so that your kingdom may be spread in throughout the world. In the name of Jesus, amen. Can you say amen? Can you clap your hands to the Lord? Can you applaud God?
You may be seated, please. For this moment, we have our announcements. I welcome again, and I would like to know if there is one here for the very first time. I would like to know you. If you are here for the very first time, please raise up your hands. We would like to know you. There is anyone? For the very first time, the second time, there is anyone here?
Yes.
Amen. Okay. So, if you are here for the very first time, you are welcome. And come again and invite your friends and relatives. The second one I would like to say that we have our grow groups is like small groups where you can be studying, learning about spiritual life and how to be growing spiritually. Amen?
Amen.
Our growth groups, we have two growing groups in the week. One in the Wednesday, 8 p.m. and the other in Saturday, 8 p.m. If you want to be joined with one of them, you have to connect to the leaders, Ladiri and Vanusa. She is here tonight. But you can be joined. If you want to be used here as a volunteer, you have to be joined at one of this group. Amen. We have to go to our welcome table and fill out a connecting card. Then you can write about your gifts and talents to be used here. We need your word here. If you are a pastor, you have to be used here. Amen. We intend to create a choir. You can participate with them at the end of the Christmas day, and you have to be joined, so to be preparing for this month, okay? The next announcement is about our social medias. We have here, you'll find us online through Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. We have our channel on YouTube. Then you can find every meeting through it. Every meeting here, you can find it through the YouTube channel. And if you are subscribed at the YouTube channel, it's very important you be subscribed. You subscribe and invite people, your friends, your relatives to subscribe. That's very important to us. Amen?
Amen.
So for this moment, we are preparing our hearts to receive the Word of God. I'd like to invite Ana Kelly. She's preacher tonight. And I'd like you to stand up, please, and let's pray for her. Amen. Raise up your hands and let's pray. Father, thank you for your presence here this night. Thank you for your daughter here. Use her as a prophet, Lord, to bring us your fresh and powerful word. You bless her, Lord, and she can be protected from every attack from the enemy. Bless your life, Lord. Use her to bring us your powerful word. Use her to bring us your fresh word this night, Lord. We are here, Lord, to receive your word and bring transformation. May you can touch everyone here. May everyone be prepared for receiving this holy word. In the name of Jesus, use her, Lord. In the name of Jesus, she is here and you can use her with boldness and power. In the name of Jesus, amen.
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 You may be seated. Don't put the slide until I sit here, okay? Thank you very much. Hello everyone again.
Hello.
I'm here to serve you now by the seed of the Word of God. And I believe that God will speak to us powerfully in the name of Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
Do you have expectations to receive the Word of God in your heart tonight?
Amen.
Because the Word of God changes us. We know that God has given us several kinds of, how can I say that, things to relate with Him. And we have worship, prayer, and we have ears to listen to the voice of the Lord. And we know as we get closer to the Lord, we'll get to know Him better, to know His heart and His intentions. And we need that because creation is nothing apart from the Creator. Amen?
Amen.
And we need God. So, before starting here, guys, let me just sit here. I would like to say to you that today you will be starting to preach on series. And during 5 or 6 weeks, we'll be bringing here messages that are about the series that we'll be working on. And today we start with the series called Communication. Amen?
Amen.
Communication. We'll be learning about that from today. And guys, we see that nowadays we have a lot of things, a lot of means of communication. We have social networkings, we have TV, internet, we have phone, cell phone, and we have letters, still we have letters, emails, a lot of kinds and means of communication, to communicate with people, with others. But even though we have a big problem of communication, we still have this problem, guys. Not only in the other areas in society, but also in the church. We have this problem. We face this problem of communication. So it means that communication is not only about having means of communication to communicate. It's not about having a bunch of tools, social networking, cell phone, and etc. It's about how to relate with people, how to express, how to communicate better. So we need to learn how to communicate with maturity. with maturity, because if there is a big problem, there is a problem of communication in society, in our personal lives, we see that in families. Families are facing this kind of problem, the problem of communication. We see that marriages are being destroyed because of bad or a poor communication. We see that families are being destroyed because of this the bad communication. And guys, we see clearly that the problem of communication produces fake news, right? Produces fake news, produces gossip. The problem of communication produces destruction, division, judgment. Why do people judge others nowadays more than before? Because of communication, because of bad communication, poor communication, immature communication. Because if we communicate well, if we guys, their communication is not just about being like me here, speaking, they're telling things. No, there is way to communicate something. You know, I don't know if you have heard about a book called The Body Speaks. Our body speaks. Our body speaks. We have gestures, yes. Look at the way that we are looking to someone, you know. In families, it's very typical when we see someone in our home. When my mom sees me in a way that she wants to share something with me, I know that she wants to talk to me. And even I have a pet, I have a dog. I learned how to communicate with a dog, and we know that dog doesn't speak. If a dog speaks, we'll be crazy. Oh, come on, God, come on. And even animals communicate with themselves or with us. A dog doesn't speak, but a dog has a way to communicate something to us. And I know my dog when she wants something to eat, and you know, when she wants a snack to eat. And we see that in the Bible, that throughout the Bible, God loves to communicate with us. All the creation communicates with the creation. Even animals, even the nature, even people, they communicate with themselves, but first with God. And by saying that, guys, I said that we have this problem of communication. Even we have several tools to communicate, to make the communication better. But because of immaturity, or because of people do not know how to express, how to communicate, how to be understood by others, we have that. But what produced the lack of communication or poor communication? We see that sin results in bad communication with people. The lack or a bad communication is the result of sin. Did you know that? Let's open our Bibles in the book of Genesis, chapter 3. And I want to speak to you today about communication, the way to communion. Guys, we were born to communicate, even with words, with touches, with, you know, feelings, sharing thoughts, and our bodies speak. Why don't you please go to the first slide? I want to share with you about communication, the way to true communion, to fellowship. And if there is no fellowship in your family, there is no good communication there. No? If sometimes people come to me, here in the church, come to me and say, "Oh, Anna, I like to be in communion with brothers and sisters. I love that. I love to have fellowship with brothers and sisters. And I don't know why it hardly happens." And we can say that it doesn't happen the way that we expected, because it is missing good communication. Good communication with each other. Of course, guys, it is not about that you have to get 1,000 people around you to communicate. No, I'm not just saying that because you have a heart attack. Heart attack, no. We will be seeing here that God wants to teach us how to improve our communication in every area of our lives in order to have better communion. And we know that relationships die because of a bad communication. We do know that, right? But let's see here in the book of Genesis, chapter 3, verse 8. I will wait for you to open the... Oh, okay, there's that. There's a text. Okay, are you here with me? In your Bible? Huh? Okay. Genesis chapter 3, verse 8, it says, "Then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and they hid from the Lord God, among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called it to man, saying, 'Where are you?' He answered, 'I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid.'" Verse 11, "And he said, 'Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree that I commanded you not to eat from?'" Just here, guys. You know this story. You know that it talks about the fall of man, the fall of Adam and Eve. And here we see clearly that the bad communication, the poor communication, begin here after they sinned. After Adam and Eve sinned, there was a problem of communication here. And you know, we see here that Adam and Eve fell into sin because of wrong communication. Why wrong communication? Why? Because they communicated with the wrong being. Who is the wrong being? Who is the wrong being that Adam and Eve communicated?
Yeah,
the devil. The devil. They were communicating with the serpent. And there is a wrong communication. We understand better why. And instead of communicating with the one to whom they were created to relate to, they were relating to the devil. And having communication with the devil, with the serpent. And their wrong communication made men to have communion with sin. To have communion with hell. Are you here? Are you getting it, guys?
Yeah.
How it's very serious. And we see that a bad communication is the result of sin. And we see here that Eve left a gap in her conversation with her husband. And Adam did the same thing with God. When God called him, "Adam, where are you? Where are you, Adam? Where are you?" And there was a gap there. There was a gap in their communication with God. And because of this gap, God needed to come and to talk to them. And then you know all this story. And guys, but the good news is that we were born again. Jesus came to restore us, to redeem us. And you know that Jesus came to restore our communication with God. Are you here?
Yeah, amen.
You know all this for here, but we are living the best days of the centuries. Jesus came. Jesus paid the price because of the sin. Because there was no communication anymore between man and God. So God sent his son so that we can have a good relationship, a good communication with our Heavenly Father, with God. And it teaches us that as the church of the Lord, guys, we need to be the best people that who have a good communication first with God and then creation builds us in every area of our life. In every area. But let's see something here. Go to the next slide, please, Wadi. What is a bad or a poor communication? And I want to tell you some of the characteristics just for you to identify if you are having a bad or poor communication with God or with people. A bad communication is to have fellowship with whom we have nothing in common. For example, when we say communication, the word communication comes from the word common. Common. And when you have communication with something or someone to whom you have nothing in common, there is a problem of communication. And for example, you have nothing in common with sin, with hell, with the wicked. You have nothing in common. There is a bad communication when you communicate wrongly with something or with someone or, you know. And also, a bad communication is to leave a gap in the conversation with those who are part of your life. How come? An example. Who is here is married. Okay, Jader knows well, right, Jader? If you leave a gap in your conversation with your wife, what will happen? Some fight. You know, guys, pay attention to those who are around you, to the people who are around you, because God is not calling you to have a good communication with all the world. No, you have a heart attack. No, you cannot. But look to those who are around you. And pay attention if you are leaving a gap in your conversation with them, in your communication, in your family, in your workplace, with your boss, with the leadership, with friends, you know? And also, wrong communication or a bad communication, it is to gossip, telling lies, to slander, to be rude with people. It's a wrong communication. It is also to direct your conversation to a wrong person that who is not involved in a given situation. An example, if you, on Monday you are not going to work, and then you think, okay, I will ask my co-worker, my colleague, to tell my boss that I will not work. That's right. Is that right? Is that right, guys?
No.
No, you need to tell directly to your boss. Directly. Because if you don't do that, that's wrong. That's a wrong communication. And the other example, a bad or a wrong communication is withholding thoughts, feelings, good actions towards someone who deserves that. An example, your spouse, your children. If you withhold your affections toward them, you are not acting in love with them, you know? And the communication involves a lot of things, but let's see some definitions about what is communication. Go to the next, please. What is communication? Let me, please, guys, open my slide here just to make it easy. What is communication according to Cambridge Dictionary? Communication is also the exchange of information and the expression of feeling that can result in understanding. Wow! It can result in understanding. You know, if we have a good communication with people, we will not judge them the way they used to judge them. Because judgment comes because of poor communication. You know? But if you communicate well, you understand a given situation, the person that you couldn't understand before. Are you here, everyone?
Yeah.
with you. And the next communication is that, yes, it's the process of sharing information, especially when this increases understanding between people or groups. Next, please, Wati. And the other, just for you to understand what you are going to speak more. Communication is to share information with others by speaking or speeches, writing, moving your body. Your body speaks. If I'm in here like these guys, what are you going to tell me that what I'm doing here?
Sleeping.
Sleeping. Right? Our body speaks. We know in the life of the King David, the Bible says that when he was full of joy, full of the presence of the Lord, he was dancing to the Lord. He was dancing. Some of you are shy because you come to church and you want to express yourself by church. I care about people who will be thinking about me. No, guys. Put your soul, your spirit, and your body in alignment to worship God. Amen. All your being needs to worship the Lord. All your being. No, sometimes I'm in my house and I have the moment of the Lord to pray, to talk to Him. And it's very interesting. It happened on Thursday, last Thursday. Guys, I was starved because those last days I'm finishing some things and I'm working with other new things and other personal things that are happening in my life. And then on Thursday I got tired. Oh my Jesus, what is going on with my mind? Today's Thursday, oh God, help me. And then I went to speak to the Lord and God just said to me, daughter, go to rest, go to sleep. And it was late, of course, and I went to sleep, and I couldn't sleep, actually. Why? Was I anxious? No, I was not anxious, but I understood that God wanted me to rest my mind, just to speak to me, just to communicate something that changes in the following days of my life. You get it? Can you believe that? As I was laid down there, God began to communicate to me specific directions to some things that I needed. And then when I got up, oh my God, I went to clean my house and I began to dance. I began to dance, I began to praise God because I was full of joy, of gratitude because of His goodness and His care, His communication. And we see that, guys, as we see in this slide, communication is also move your body, and or using other signals. We have that language called in Brazil, Libra. It's a kind of communication as well, and other kinds of communication. And the next one is to talk about your thoughts, feelings, and helping other people to understand them. So communication is about relationship. The next please, what is it? It's about relationship. But let's see, in the Bible, guys, why communication is very important to us and for us? Why? Because communication brings understanding. Maybe sometimes you are not understanding what is going on in your life and what a situation happened that way, but try to communicate with people involved in that situation. Because communication brings understanding. In Portuguese, compreensão. I love that word. Compreensão, understanding people. Okay? And communion. Also, according to the Cambridge Dictionary, communion is a close relationship with someone in which feelings and thoughts are exchanged. is also the condition or an act of sharing thoughts or feelings. Okay, the next part is a group of people who are united by the same, especially religious beliefs. The Church of the Lord. The Church of the Lord needs to communicate in order to have true communion. And what is communion in Greek word in the Bible? Let's see here what it means. What is communion? Communion is fellowship, from the word koinonia, koinonia from Greek. And it means participation or social intercourse, fellowship, intimacy, communion, communication, distribution, contribution, and to communicate. So guys, that is in the Bible. The Bible teaches us to communicate well and to have koinonia, to have fellowship, communion with others. And what are the kinds of communication that we need to improve in our lives? What is the communication? I believe that we need to improve in every sense. In every sense, we need to improve our communication. And I remember, guys, that in the past, with everyone outside, I knew how to communicate in my workplace, but I wasn't seen. I was sinning against my family because I was not improving my communication with them. And then I learned from Jesus, how to communicate first with God, and then with our families, and with our family, and then with the outsiders. Amen? Are you here?
Amen.
Are you understand, everyone?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Say, amen. Can you say, I got it?
Okay.
Praise God. And the first kind of communication that we need to improve is the next one. The next slide, please. Yes, here we are. The first communication that we need to improve our communication with God. We see, as I said to you, everyone, that throughout the Bible and since the world is born, God is the God who loves to communicate with us. He loves, He is a relational God, and He loves communicating with humanity. He loves to communicate with you. Did you know that? Did you know that every single day, God has been preparing a banquet before you and calling you to have intimacy with you, but you leave a gap in your conversation with God? You cannot leave a gap in this communication with Him. And we see, guys, that God loves to communicate. Let's see in Jeremiah, next slide, Matthew. In Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 3, it says, what God says, call to me. God is saying to you, everyone, call to me and I will answer you. And I will tell you great and unsearchable things you do not know. Wow. God is saying, oh, come on. My son, my daughter, communicate with me, God is saying. Communicate with me. And I will not leave a gap in our conversation. I will answer you. God doesn't leave a gap in our conversation with Him. He always answers you. And you know why you have no direction for your life? Do you know why? You have no guidance, no direction. And if you don't know what to do in any area of your life, do you know why? Because of that. Because you are not communicating to God, with God. You are not calling God. And God is inviting you. Hey, come on. Let's communicate. Let's talk. And do you remember what is communication? Communication is sharing thoughts, sharing feelings, information. And God, God knows everything. Okay, He knows everything. But He gives you an opportunity for you to open your heart, you know, to express yourself. and to pour out yourself before Him, before His feet. And He invites you, come, call to me, and I will give the answer that you want. I will give you direction, and I will tell you great and unsearchable things you do not know. God wants to communicate unsearchable things that are hidden before you because you have not communicated with God. But as you communicate with Him, He will answer you. And the next, in the book of Matthew chapter 6, Jesus says, but when you pray, what is prayer, guys? What is prayer? Prayer is our communication with God. Prayer is not a ritual. Oh, I'll come before the sovereign Lord. I will change my voice. Oh, sovereign Lord, please come. No. Just be yourself before Him. Just communicate and share your thoughts. Pray to God. Communicate. Go. And Jesus says, when you pray, if Jesus says when, it means that Jesus is expecting something from you. Jesus has an expectation that you go to pray, that you go to seek after God's presence. Jesus has that expectation, but you insist to leave a gap in your communication with Him. But guys, in the name of Jesus, from today on, we'll change that in our lives. Amen? Amen? Even in this pandemic context, we need more than ever seeking after God's presence. And maybe you have no job, you have no direction, and God wants to give you new ideas, new strategy. God wants you to be in your room, praying to Him, communicating, open your heart to Him about your doubts. Oh, but I don't like to question God. I don't like to ask Him why. No, please, come on, calm down. Take it easy, everyone. God doesn't get offended if you ask Him something that you don't understand. Go to Him and ask Him. Whatever you are in your mind, in doubt, in the, question Him, you can do that, okay? And in the certain moment, in the right moment, God will answer you because He doesn't leave a gap in your communication with Him, in His communication with you. And then Jesus says, when you pray, when you communicate with God, go away by yourself. Be alone with God. Be alone with Him. Shut the door behind you and pray to your Father in private. Yes. Then your Father, who sees everything, will reward you. God sees everything, and He will reward you, He will answer you, He will communicate with you. We need to train our spiritual ears to listen to the voice of the Lord, to recognize His voice, because He's telling us something every single day, guys. And we have to do as David did. The Bible says in the Psalm 27 that David was praying, hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice, and be gracious to me, and answer me. And then, in the verse 8, God answers David, and God says, when you said, God says, seek my face, David. And David answered and replied in again, my heart said to you, your face, O Lord, I will seek. Guys, we need to improve our communication with God. If we want to have breakthroughs in our lives, we need to improve our communication with the heavens. And some of you are here waiting to go to heaven. When I go to heaven, I will not face this, I will not face that. Oh, come on guys, Jesus taught us how to pray. Your kingdom come. When Jesus taught us to pray, your kingdom come, Jesus was saying, make heavens come and your will be done. That means that we can live the blessings of heavens in our life. But we need to improve our communication with God. How has been, how has your communication with God been? Are you communicating with Him every day or once a week? Can you imagine, for those who are parents, who are spouses, who are children, son or daughter, can you imagine if you go through a week without speaking to your family, ignoring your family? God is your family. God is your Father. Stop neglecting His presence. Stop ignoring God's presence. And you know why it is important to improve our communication with God? Because communication with God transforms us. We are not the same when we relate to God. We are not the same when we communicate with Him every day. Every day. Communicating with God protects us from the serpent's schemes, from the devil's traps. Communication with God will prevent us from gossiping. Let me teach you something. Whenever you want to gossip or to slander someone, speaking wrongly about someone, don't go to anyone else. Go to the Lord. Go to the Lord and tell Him everything that you wanted to say about that person. And God will show you the right perspective about that situation. So communication with God helps us to avoid sins with mouth. And communication with God, next, this one, it helps us to communicate well with people. And the next, please, what you let me, yes, please. And another point, communication is very important. Can you see that until here? That communication, we need to improve, guys, communication. The next, what you. And why we need to improve, why communication is very important. Because communication, communication is important. Yes. Why communication is very important, guys? Communication is important for relationships. If you say that you have a relationship with God and you don't communicate with Him, sorry, but you don't have a true relationship with God. You have a religion. You have a religion. You believe God is real, but you don't have a true relationship with God. Because relationship requires communication, communion, fellowship. And good communication we are made for relationship, guys. And a good communication leads us to communion, to fellowship. And you know, some of you, maybe when you go to pray alone, to be with God, you feel that moment is boring. It's boring. Oh God, it's boring. I cannot stand here for 5 minutes. You don't take pleasure in God's presence. You know why? Because you are not religion. Religion, probably. And why? Oh no, I'm not in a religious life. So you have a choice. Begin to communicate well with God. From today, improve your communication with the Holy Spirit, with the presence of God, in order to have fellowship, communion. When you go from that moment, from that place of that boring place, when you go from the place that you are not taking pleasure of His presence, and that you go further, you go deeper in God's presence, then you have communion, fellowship, and that you see, spiritually saying, you see a table prepared before you with everything that you need to eat from God's presence. You'll be there eating because God has prepared that table for you to eat, for you to eat every day from His table, to drink from His cup. Improve your relationship with Him. So you have fellowship. And when you have fellowship, you begin to know God's heart. And God will show you your heart and will align your life with Him. And the consequence is that I said that we need to improve our communication, our prayer life with God. And then the next, please. And then the consequence that if you have good communication with God, you will communicate well with other people. You communicate well with them because relating to God molds us to relate well with people. And guys, my brothers and sisters, begin to think about your family, your friends, your marriage, your workplace, your boss, your colleagues, your co-workers. Begin to think about them. And how has your relationship been with those people, with them? You need to improve your relationship with them. From the place of a good communication with God, you have a true and good relationship with others as you communicate with them well. It also talks about transparency, is this word in English? Transparency. That is more, you know, and you bring you authenticity. You bring you that, guys, to be a Christian, because true Christian value communication with God and with others, with other people. And know that there is no true relationship without communication and communion, fellowship. If you say, oh, I have a relationship with that person, with those people, but if you don't have a good communication, that relationship is broken. That relationship is poor. Guys, communication builds relationship. If you want to love more your family, if you want to love those that you think that they don't deserve to be loved, begin to communicate with them well. Maybe you are wrong about them. I suppose that you lead this experience about looking to someone and saying to that person, and you don't like that person, and you just judge that person. But experience it, to speak to that person, speak to that guy, and you begin to understand his or her heart. And you begin to create a relationship. We know, of course, that for every kind of relationship, we have a kind of barriers that we need to place, of course. Because relationship is not something that is built overnight. This is something that is built day by day, communicating every day. And I told you that I have a terrible communication with my family in the past. And nowadays, praise be God for that, they are my best friends. My parents, my brother, my family. And you know why? Because as you communicate, and communication is not just, guys, I love to speak. You know, some of you know here, all of you have received the audio in the WhatsApp Live podcast, right? Me, Jade, Sonia, também, also. Because I love to speak, but communication is not just speaking, but also listening. listening people, and I learned how to listen my family and to learn from them, and I begin to love them more and more. And it happens, guys, as you communicate well with people, you love them more and more. You know, we see relationships, and I remember that my parents some a few years ago they were participating in a course for married couples, and they were saying that some marriages are being destroyed because you think that you know your spouse enough, and you stop communicating, you stop searching her or his heart. And it is also for all kinds of relationships, friendships, in your workplace, your colleagues, and also communication is a sign of consideration and respect towards someone. I remember it happened close to you when I lived here a few years ago. That time I was working at a hospital and I was going to work. And God said to me, I saw a woman coming up the wall and the house going down. And God said to me, my God, why have you ignored that woman? And I'm like, oh God, come on, I don't know her, I don't know. And God taught me how to say just, good morning, hello, how are you? Even you have no intimacy, you cannot ignore people. Guys, God loves people. Did you know that? Did you know that God loves people, and because of that, God is not silent. God is communicating to people every day. People are getting saved because God has been communicating with them, presenting Jesus. The same with us. We cannot ignore people. Just say, guys, when you leave your house, when you leave your home to work, just say good morning. That costs nothing. You're not taking one real from your pocket. Okay? Just be gentle. Communication is about maturity, gentleness. It's about kindness. It's about understanding people, respecting them, and know that no communication, no possibility for communion, for fellowship, and intimacy. Maybe some of you are complaining about the church, oh, the church nowadays, there is no fellowship, there is no communication. But let me ask you a question. How do you communicate with your local church? How do you communicate with the members of that church, with the leadership? How do you communicate? If you want something, you need to see a seed. No, to sow a seed. If you want something, you need to be the first person to take an action. Stop being in a place of passivity. Self-pity also. Be the first person to say something to know others, because true relationship, communication builds a good relationship, and true relationship leads to communion, both with God and with people. And I saw this phrase in the website of Cambridge. It says, if two people communicate with each other, they are able to understand each other and have a satisfactory relationship. You get it? You get it?
Yeah, yes.
Amen. And finally, go to the next, please. I said that communication leads us to communion fellowship. There is no true relationship without communion and the communication. There is no. I invite you, everyone, to evaluate, to see your relationships. Maybe you say, oh, that person didn't call me last month. That person, I think that she or he has something against me. I brother, my sister, go to that person and speak, talk to her, to him. Go to that person. The Bible teaches us that. Jesus taught us when we have something in our hearts against someone, go and ask that person. Oh, my brother, my sister, you have something against me. What is going on? Just be. I do that. I used to do that. When I feel my heart and I first separate, because some things are impressions of our minds and you know, guys. And anything that I'm saying here is not about emotional dependence. Emotional dependence is harmful. God is not saying, is not telling you to be, how can I say, very close to someone and grab that person. No, no, it is not about that. True communication has balance, maturity. And that emotional dependence is very harmful. Don't be emotionally dependent on someone else, please. Oh, I go to the church if that person will go. I'll go with her, with him. No, guys, come on. Oh, I will do that, I will take that, I will make that decision if my friend does the same decision. Come on. There is emotional dependence. Come down. And every day you want to speak to a friend, to that friend. Hey, God doesn't want you to be dependent on someone else. Emotionally. Okay? Are you here with me?
Yes.
That's not normal to depend on another emotionally. To depend for everything. To think about the person. No, guys. Communication is not about that. Communication is about relationship. And relationship, from God's point of view, has balance. Okay? Has self-control as well. Alright? You must be dependent on God. Completely. I mean emotionally, spiritually. And with friends, we have balance. We learn from each other. Go to the next place, Wadi. And we see here the benefits of a good communication and communion. Go to the next. And we see, according to the Bible, in Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 3, the Bible says that when we have a good communication with God, we receive direction. Guidance. And according to Psalm 133, we receive the blessing of the Lord. Because the Bible says, how pleasant it is when the people of God are gathered together, there God will command his blessings. And you know, good communication plus communion bring blessings from God. You get it? Good communication brings blessing. It means several kinds of blessing. And good communication makes us be one in Christ with the same principles. And also maturity. Guys, no one grows apart from relationship. No one can grow without relationship, without communication. Because when we communicate with each other, we grow, we learn something. We learn something from each other, okay? It brings us growth. We can grow, we can mature. We can learn things that we didn't know before. The next, please, Wadi. And other benefits. I said that we can show respect towards someone. And we learn from each other. When we communicate well, okay? That's amazing. And also it brings health to our soul. For example, sometimes, how many of you have the experience that you needed to speak to someone and that you were very broken in your emotion, in your heart, and then after that conversation, you were restored. You are healed in your emotions. Why? Because you received encouragement. And the Bible says that the words of the wise brings healing to our soul. Good communication brings healing, great counsel to for anything that we need. And the good communication makes strong our relationships as family, friends. Guys, relationships cannot survive without communication. Cannot survive without that. And we need to improve that. The next three Sundays we'll be speaking more about communication. But understand that communion comes after communication. And communication is about sharing again your thoughts, heart, talking, seeking what is common among us. The next, please, Wadi. So, just the conclusion, we need to improve our communication with God, and the consequence is that we will improve our communication with people. Guys, I also remember that when I was younger, years ago, when I came to Jesus, okay? When I came to Jesus, it was hard for me to speak publicly. It was hard for me to express myself. I used it to hide myself from others, even the church. I didn't like to be together. I didn't like to communicate to people, to my brothers and sisters. I didn't like that. And why? Because I had problems, my soul, my emotions, I needed to be healed. But the healing was in the communion. And then, day by day, Jesus taught me how to be in communion, how to speak to my friends in Christ, to my brothers and sisters. And you know how God can transform. Now I'm here speaking to you. But it was hard for me. It was hard to develop friendships with several people. It was hard. And I want to say to you, if you have this difficulty, if it is hard for you to communicate with others, check your heart. Or maybe if it is easy for you to have relationship just with one or two people, check your heart. Because maybe it is a dependence, emotional dependence, you know? I had that in the past. Check your heart and allow God to heal you, to bring you restoration. And know that the restoration that you need is here, in the community of God. Community, the word community, comes from communion, comes from communication. And then, the second consequence, finally, is that we'll communicate about the gospel of Christ with the world. Communicating with God, communicating with our brothers and sisters and friends and families will help us to be witnesses of Jesus. Because if you don't have a good communication with God, with the people of God, with our brothers and sisters, with our families, with our colleagues, and you know, we won't be able to communicate the gospel to the world and to bring other people to the communion with Jesus. Can you stand up, please? Here we finish. Here. And I'd like to invite the worship team to finish this moment. And again, check your heart, search your heart, and see what are the relationships that you need to make strong. To learn how to communicate with the people around you. The next Sunday we'll be speaking more. But search your heart about that. Ask the Lord, Lord, help me. I'm terrible by communicating. I'm terrible at that. Maybe you have the problem of emotional dependence. Put it before the Lord, before His presence. Because as we say, the presence of the Lord is here. It's here. God has spoken to you? Has God spoken to you? Just to know. Has God spoken to you tonight?
Amen.
Amen. Let's make strong our communication with Him, with people, all the people around you, around us, and then to communicate this God, this loving God, to the world. Close your eyes just to pray. Oh, why I need to close my eyes? Just to focus. It's you and God. It's you and the Holy Spirit. Just to focus. Search your heart. Be sincere with yourself.
Thank you.
Communicate with him.
with God and other people, your parents, your friends, and your brothers. In the name of Jesus, have a blessed week. We love you and God bless you. See you next Sunday. Amen. After the worship team finish, you are dismissed. In Jesus' name, amen.